Welcome back learners. In this session we are going to understand the performance assessment and performance review method. The performance planning and execution part, this is the extended part of it. As in the last lecture we have seen what is performance planning and how it is executed and how the managers plan the review, the results, behaviors and development plans. In this session our learning objectives will be to understand the execution of the assessment process and to understand the execution of review process. So how it actually happens on the floor. So what is assessment? It is the evaluation of the results being achieved by the employers or to whomsoever the targets were given. Now both the employee and manager are responsible for this assessment. Let's understand how it happens. The employees are supposed to assess themselves first. There comes an assessment form which they have to fill and which helps them to understand their own performance, their own expectations and the effectivity of their work. The assessment is done mostly direct by the direct supervisor or immediate whosoever the supervisor to the employee is, and this supervisor is supposed to provide the information about his subordinate. It also evaluates the results with the development plans, whether the results of the performance by the employees match the development plans or not. Are they going to fulfill the organizational objectives or not? How far behind they are or how well they are doing, this can be assessed. So the ownership of the process lies with both manager and employee. So what happens here is it is a self view and views of the supervisor which is being assessed. The self appraisal forms come which the employees fill and it helps to reduce the defensiveness of the employee during meeting. Meetings are the part of performance reviews wherein the employee faces immediate manager and they exchange the performance of the employees. This technique also increases the employee's satisfaction with overall performance management system. He is given a feeling that he is being heard and his challenges are being noted and actions are taken over them. It also enhances the perception of accuracy and fairness by the employees, and employee involvement is supposed to increase the commitment by them. So this process is a part, this process is important for both the employees and managers as they take the responsibility of it, and manager fills out the appraisal forms, employee also fills this form, and the fact that both parties are involved in the process provides the good information to be used in the review phase, which is a later phase when both these employees and the supervisor are active participants in the evaluation process. There is a greater likelihood that the information will be used productively in the future. Specifically, the inclusion of self-rating helps the employee to emphasize possible discrepancies between the self-views and views by his or her manager. Any differences between the views of these two will be a subject matter to discuss in the meeting. Now friends, let us again review this case by ENSR. Here the tool they are using is balance scorecard. Balance scorecard is a tool which is used to assess the performance of the different departments. Now when the organization is having one objective of, and that is also for 5 years, that is regarding health and safety, employee engagement, etc. They have also include client loyalty. So how one will come to know what client's loyalty is and how we can assess it? So there will be some categories under this label, client loyalty, and the company will see if it meets the client loyalty through those points. This is one example I have quoted here, which is used for performance management. So performance can be regarding individual, team, or process also. So the company will have to set some measurement scales to tap those performances. Now after this performance assessment, there comes a performance review. When the employees are rating themselves through self-appraisal forms, their ratings are being cross-checked by their managers, and there has to be one agreement between both the views. If that agreement, or if the level of agreement deviates a lot, then it becomes a topic to discuss in the review meeting. Performance reviews are nothing but something which includes meetings or discussions. They are one-on-ones and face-to-face communications between the employee and the manager. The performance feedback is given to the person, and whosoever is interviewing or them or asking them, for example, in this case, the manager of the employee, that manager is given proper training to take that feedback and to discuss or to conduct the meeting with its subordinate. Why this training is required? Because when the meeting happens, it is really not a pleasant thing for the employee. Friends, no employee like these kind of meetings where he has already put or filled his form and rated himself, and he knows that he is not rating himself to the full, he has not scored the full marks on some of the categories or many of them. So facing again a meeting on the same topic becomes difficult for him and unpleasant. One may become defensive, or one may become overconfident and overrating himself. So to avoid all these deviations, a proper training is given to the manager, and he is also trained how to record the feedbacks and communicate them further. So in review, there are 6 recommendation steps for conducting the productive performance reviews. Let's see what these 6 are. First, identifying what the employee has done well and poorly by citing specific positive or negative behaviors. So it is not just about the work on paper, it is also a non-verbal behavior that is being recorded. Remember, friends, in the last few lectures we have discussed that the manager is responsible to note every good and bad behavior of the employee. So first is identifying what he has done good or bad. Secondly, soliciting the feedback from the employee about these behaviors and listening for reactions and explanations. So one can tally that this particular behavior was the result of particular situation or perception by the employee. So it is being solicited. Later, discussing the implications of changing or not changing the behaviors. So positive feedback is the best one, but if an employee has a negative feedback, then he must be made aware of that, and what will be the consequences of his poor performance should be communicated to him. So friends, try to understand what is happening here. The good behavior is being appreciated. If the poor behavior is there, it's been notified, and all the after effects are also being communicated. So it makes the employee alert on those particular areas of improvement, and there is a sense, or there is a kind of motivation he gets if there he finds a little bit fear of those negative consequences, it can motivate him in other way to improve his performance. Later stage includes explaining the employee how skills used in the past achievement can help him overcome any current performance problems. So here the role of manager is very important. What he is doing, he is trying to identify, trying to tell him what he can improve, how he has done well, and he is also being a motivator, trying to boost his performance. Next comes is being agree on the action plan. So here manager also has to confirm that the employee will be ready to improvise himself or herself. He encourages the employee to invest in improving his performance by asking questions. These questions can be a series of questions. Some of them may be, what ideas do you have for XYZ problem? Or what suggestions do you have for improving your performance in this area? What do you think how you can improve? What are the challenges if you decide to improvise and could not do it? So this is how the manager becomes a mentor here. And the last stage is to set up a meeting to follow and agree on the behaviors, actions and attitude to be evaluated. Because it is a later stage, it has to be scheduled, and that's why we are here. It is said that it is a setting up a meeting to follow up. So follow-ups are ensured by the managers. So friends, these are the six recommended steps for conducting any productive performance review. Please remember that this is a review stage and not assessment, and that's why after assessment, whatever there was in the meeting or there was on the forms which can be questionable, it is tried to be sorted out in this meeting. So face-to-face communication, confronting or facing your areas of improvement, trying to identify what caused those poor performances, and also ensuring that some techniques, methods or ways can be applied to improvise those poor performances. So this is how the review works. So reviewing is just not about looking at the papers and scores and telling, okay, categorizing it whether it was poor or best. Reviews also include taking further action plans to improvise them. Sometimes if it is identified that it is not going to improvise at all, then some other options can be worked out by the manager, or even if they are not possible, then it may lead to the extreme actions. Yet it is the preference of any organization not to go extremes and try to solve them in subtle ways, so that it will not create any conflict and it will give a sense of responsibility to the employee, as he is also responsible for his own behavior and performance. So after these two important stages, the final stage is performance renewal and recontracting. We'll not go much deeper into it. This is just the winding up of the review process, and this is the final stage which uses the insights and information from the previous stages of assessment and review. This stage is used for further goal setting, or it may also happen that the manager finds that the goals set for the employee were too high or too low, which may reveal his overperformance or underutilization of the capacities. It may be communicated further and the changes in goals can be set. So friends, this is how the performance assessment and review techniques work in the execution of performance planning. Until I bring you the next management lesson, keep learning and keep watching. Thank you.